Hey guys, so you started your own t-shirt business and you're starting to learn how to do graphic designing and you're stuck on a situation where you want to insert an object or an image into a font or another object as well, but you just don't know how. And the only resources that you have available to you is those expensive softwares that allow you to do it called power clipping. So I'm going to show you a simple process how to do the same features without that expensive software by using the power of Canva. Hey, this is Anthony from Rocket Prints, and thanks for watching this video. On this channel, I provide you walkthrough tutorials from graphic designing to digitizing images for heat pressing t-shirts and embroidery. And on this channel for today, we are going to show you how to use the power of Canva, grabbing an image and inserting it into another image. Now, it might be a little tedious because you're going to have to do some other steps, but I guarantee you, once it's done, you're going to realize that you don't need that special software to do something like this, and you can go ahead and start getting creative and doing your own thing to help you generate your own sales, right? So today we're going to take this object, which is going to be a vase. We're going to take like an image of old newspaper and we're going to insert it into the vase. After that, we're going to create like a canvas picture and we're going to see how this one turns out. All right. So first things first is I'm going to walk you through this tutorial. So grab your pen, paper, and let's go ahead and get this started. All right. So first, what we're going to do is we are going to select our canvas board. So I'm just going to go to file here. I'm going to create a new design. And I am going to look for custom size, right? I'm gonna click the biggest size I can find. And the reason why you wanna create something on a big canvas, it's easier to just shrink it down if you realize that you messed up, that then having to start all over and increase the size, download it into a PNG file, it's just a big mess. So the bigger it is, the easier it is to get your stuff done. All right, so. Okay, and then from here, we're gonna go to elements and we are going to look for a vase. So I already had selected a vase here. I just typed in under elements in the search engine. I look for vase and here I got my vase. And if you can see right there, inside this vase is, it's white, right? It's got a white background. So you really can't put anything in it if I go to layer to the back, you see it's white, right? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get rid of the white in the back. So how we're gonna do that is we are just going to go back to elements. We're gonna go to our shape tool. Okay, and then we're just gonna bring this shape around the whole vase, okay? All right, and then now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and layer this to the back. All right, now the vase is up front. And then from here, we're gonna simply go to share and we're gonna download this bad boy. All right, now you have these features, limit file size, compressed file, lower quality, transparent background. You're not gonna select any of those. You're just gonna click download. Okay, and then once that is downloaded, you can see up here, you're just gonna simply add another page. You're gonna grab your download and you're gonna drag it in here. Okay, and then go ahead and blow this up a little bit. All right, it don't matter how big you want it, okay? And then from here, we're gonna go to background remover. Now, I have this toolbar set up and before, there was an upgrade on Canva and now I have this toolbar, but before you didn't have this toolbar, you had to go to edit and then it would give you the pictures on the left and you can go to BG remover, which is background remover, and you click that where the little beach ball is. But now they gave you like a shortcut here and you can just click on it. Okay, so we're just gonna click on background remover. And we are going to get rid of that white background in the vase. Okay, so once it's stopped, now if you want to see how it's going to look after that, you can see now that it's hollow. All right, so we're just going to go back and we're going to click out of this. all I did was just click background remover again. Okay, so from here, what you're gonna do now is you're just going to color this, okay? So we're gonna make this all white. So how we're gonna do that is we're gonna go back to edit, and we're gonna go to a feature called under effects. It's gonna be called dual tone. We're gonna click that, and we're gonna click up here where it says custom, okay? And we're gonna change the highlights and the shadows to solid white. So if you look right there, you could see underneath when I put the mouse pad over it, the mouse pointer over this section, you're gonna see some wording under there. That is the description of the color. So pound EEEEE stands for gray, okay? Gives it a gray format. So we want F. We want it all Fs, okay? So that's what we're gonna do. You can see there, now it's changed to F. We're gonna do the same thing. Oops, I got out of it by accident. Let's go back. And we're gonna change this. We're simply just gonna grab this little cursor here, and we're gonna move that all the way to it changes to F, okay? And you don't even have to grab that. You can just type in the numbers here and it'll change it for you, okay? So now that we have that format just like that, now we can go ahead and bring in our newspaper. Okay, so we're gonna go back to Elements. We're gonna grab our newspaper, and I found newspaper under Elements too. Under Graphics, I just found this. And what we're gonna do now is we are going to layer this again. We're gonna send to back. And you can see now it's starting to look like that image is part of the vase. Okay, so how do you get rid of this part here, the excess, right? Well, that's why you had that first background to help you get rid of it. Okay, so now what we gotta do is we're gonna go to positions. And if you can't grab the inside of here, all you need to do is just go to positions here, click on it, and you're gonna select layers, and you're gonna click on the newspaper because we wanna close that off to the white. So we're just gonna close this. Close this part off. See how it's starting to come around? Okay, so I'm gonna show you something here. So you still have this background, you have your canvas board, right? And then you got the newspaper in the back, and then you have this white border, the white square in the back. What we wanna do now is we wanna turn this into a single PNG file just with the vase alone. So all we're gonna do now, re-download this one more time to get rid of those two things, okay? So we're just gonna go to share, we're gonna go to download again, and we're not gonna select anything again, although you can hit transparency background, but that's not necessary. We can do this all together here. So we're just gonna click on this, we're gonna go to page 2, we're gonna download it again, and then from here, we're gonna create our third page, okay? Let's let that download. All right, now the third page is done. Okay, and then now you see we got rid of the newspaper, and all we have now is the white square in the back. So all we got to do now is just hit background remover, and you'll see the change right here. Check this out. Boom, it is done. Now you have your own image that you were trying to create without any of the other stuff. So that will show up, if you don't do this process, that will show up on your images if you're trying to add it onto a black t-shirt or a colored t-shirt. That will show up. That's why you have to get rid of that other stuff, okay? So now you can go to your colors here. So let's go back to your background, and you can go to black, and it's there. Okay, so if I did it here and I went to black, oops, I'm sorry, and I went to the canvas and I typed it, and I don't know why it keeps doing that. So if I went to here and I went to the canvas and I went to black, you're gonna see that square, right? So that's why you wanna get rid of it, okay? So let's go back here. Let's go back to canvas, to this canvas, and let's change that color back to white. And let's go ahead and make some use out of this picture so you can get some ideas that why it's necessary to do stuff like this, because it can just enhance your designs by 100% with your creativity, and you got more options to do to make your t-shirts or to make other stuff, right? So I use Printify, and right now they have some canvas that you can do, and that's why I want to do this, because I'm starting to make designs on canvas items and trying to market them and sell them, right? So we're just gonna make a simple design here. So I'm gonna do is I'm just going to blow up the screen so you can see it without my video on the side. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go back to Elements, and I'm gonna select a kind of cartoonish park feel, and we're gonna click here. So I selected an image that I thought was cool. We're gonna click on here. We're just gonna blow this up. Okay, we're gonna blow this to the whole square, and then I'm just going to layer this in the back. I'm gonna keep my vase, and I'm gonna add a picnic table. Put the picnic table right there. We're gonna put our vase. We're just gonna shrink this bad boy down. All right, and we're gonna bring the vase up front. So it looks like it's really sitting on the image. So let's do this. Let's just bring this over here in the grass. There we go. Put the vase there. And of course we want some flowers in that vase. So we're gonna put the vase, put some flowers in this vase. And we're going to bring that vase up forward one more time. All right. Okay. All right, now what we're gonna do is grab somebody who's gonna admire that vase, right? This lady's just taking a stroll in the park, and she sees this vase, and she's just admiring the beauty of those flowers. And last thing we need is Spot. Let's bring Spot in here just to give it some character and some fun. So there you go, guys. By applying this simple step, it can help increase your sales for your e-commerce store or your t-shirt business. Now that you have this skill under your belt, you don't need that other software like CorelDRAW or Photoshop. You can apply this simple trick using the power of Canva. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. I would love to hear your feedback. And if you found value in this video, please give me a thumbs up, as it's going to help support my channel out tremendously. And if you like this video and you want to see more content such as this, subscribe to my channel. So with that, you have a blessed week and a blessed day, and we'll see you guys back on my next video next week, and peace.